because of globalization and technology, old structures, old hierarchies, old relationships have broken down. And new patterns, still unclear, are forming. In families, in school, in churches and temples and mosques, in the workplaces, in NGOs. And all kinds of groups are mushrooming, which are viable because they can link up with people in other countries. I get lobbied by the Cat Welfare Association, by the Dogs for Blind People Association, by those who fly kites, by those who race quarter-scale cars, by many others. In our system, unless it comes under People's Association, getting approvals is often not easy. This problem, which causes a lot of pent-up frustration, I think it's a deep problem, not a simple problem. And it's not a problem just of the government, because at the core of the government is a PAP. This problem is also in the PAP. Because, like everybody else in the world, we have to adjust to the new technology, to the new social forces at work, which are breaking up people into small groups and find a way to create a new unity. And we can only create a new unity if we talk. If we talk to one another. If we listen. If we listen to one another. Which means respect. Which means trust. Respect and trust take a long time to build up. They can be easily destroyed. But it is something that we have to do. And something which, if we do well, will create a new unity similar to the unity that we had, which created Singapore, which an earlier generation had to create Singapore with Lee Kuan Yew. In your hearts, you know that Singapore needs the PAP. That without the PAP, there is no Singapore. But we need a transformed PAP. It doesn't mean that all our problems will be solved. But it means that there will be better communication and a greater feeling for people. Years ago, when I first became an MP, when I conducted an MPS, I remembered what the doctor told me. That you can rarely cure a serious illness. You can only sometimes cure a serious illness. You can often ameliorate, which means make it less painful. And he said, you can always comfort. I took that to heart. That at MPSs, as MPs, this must be our approach. We cannot solve all problems. Sometimes we can make it easier for people by giving them vouchers, by financial help, doing something on the side for them. But we can always comfort. And we comfort by a listening ear. Let people complete their sentences before interrupting them. That is very important. Because it is only when they feel they've communicated that they're prepared to receive. And that's why they attend Workers' Party rallies, because they want the loudspeaker to blare so loud that we have to hear it. And they're still, they're not so sure. What we need is to hear these things ourselves. In the last 9 days, the five of us candidates, we have had intense discussion. This has been the most intense election campaign that I've ever had. It is my sixth. And we talked about many things. We talked about the things that are right. We talked about the things that are wrong. We talked about things that we have to do after the elections. And we've all come to the conclusion that the PAP itself must be transformed. But before I made this speech, before, as I was drafting this speech, I spoke to Prime Minister because I knew he was coming to support us this evening. I said, PM, this is what I'm going to say. PM said, George, you and your teammates, say what is in your hearts. And reflect what is in the hearts of ordinary people. He said he will listen. He will listen hard. This is what we must do. But I need your help. I need your help because for us to have a voice in parliament, in government, in the PAP, we need a strong mandate. The stronger, the better. The stronger the mandate, the more influence we will be able to wield. You know, we live in an exciting part of the world. The American economy is not very good. The European economies are in trouble, deep problems. Young Americans, young Europeans, they are coming here, looking for opportunities. China, changing beyond belief. When I first went to my ancestral town in Ang Po, near Teochew, where my mother came from, it was such a poor place. I had to learn how to draw water from a well and how to do my business outdoors. In the evening at 8 p.m., the light became dim. There were no refrigerators. And so what leftover food they had, they boiled to kill the germs to keep till tomorrow. Today, when I visit my cousins, because the old ones have passed away, they drive me around their BMWs, they treat me to banquets, they show me their bungalow houses. And this is all over China. And on the other side, there's India. Also growing in a different way, but growing. I've been to many parts of India. You know I've been involved in the Nalanda project. And I thank Mr. Lee Bok Guan for coming here this evening to show us support. I'm very grateful to him. Even a poor state like Bihar is making growth of over 10% a year. There's Vietnam, there's Indonesia. The whole region around us, 2 billion people, half the, 3 billion people, half the world's population, is on the move. And we are right in the middle. How can our future not be bright? If we are united, and we have very good relations with all our major trading partners. And I was involved in forging those relations as trade minister and as foreign minister. There are so many things that we can do, so many opportunities for Singaporeans. The sky's the limit, the world's our oyster. Provided we are united. If we are divided, there'll be problems, big problems. This destiny, our destiny in this century, is in our own hands. And this election in Aljunied is important not only for the people who live here, but for the whole of Singapore. give us a strong mandate, we will work for a government and the PAP that will be able to create a new unity in Singapore, understand and overcome many of the frustrations that are now prevalent. We may not be able to solve all of them, but we can ameliorate some of them, and we can be comforting to everybody. If we do that, it'll be a different Singapore. Remember, the Aljunied election is of decisive importance. On nomination day, I describe it as a chuechan, a decisive battle. It is a decisive battle. It was a decisive battle deliberately provoked by Mr. Lau Tia Kiang. We have to win it. And we have to win it decisively. And we must fight for the transformation of the PAP and achieve this new unity. This is really a struggle for the soul of Singapore. A struggle for the soul of Singapore. And in this struggle, we are all on the same side. All political parties are on the same side. All of us are on the same side. Let us work together. And we have to work together. And renew hope in the Singapore we love. Live or die, we who are here will work with you to make it happen. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. 谢谢我们的领区部长杨龙文先生为我们演说。
Thank you, Minister.